Sam Allred pulled up lame today. Steve Anderson is with us for the weather. Send Sam out to be here. We got a nice, pleasant afternoon. He's been worrying about thunderstorms all week, and this is a beauty out there.
Yeah, poor guy couldn't be on today to forecast good weather. Yeah. I'm going to take all the credit, folks. We've got something to talk about. It's rainfall. You won't believe this, but there was only 44 hundredths of an inch at Stapleton Airport officially. Other areas, though, had something more than that. Take a look at this. This is a three-day storm total, Tuesday through Thursday. Stapleton, as you can see, there it is. Other areas go from an inch and a half at Littleton all the way up to about 4 1/10 inches at Loveland. All of those figures, of course, are the storm total, Tuesday through Thursday. La Junta yesterday alone had nearly 2 inches, but those are some of the figures that we have available to us now. Currently 76 degrees, 24 Celsius. The relative humidity is 47%. Very muggy out there. Winds northeasterly at 7. The pressure falling. It's at 30.12. We are picking up ground targets around the Lyman radar site. Other than that, Pikes Peak to the west of Colorado Springs, some showers to the southwest of Denver. Some have been heavy today in central and southern Jefferson County. The other area with showers has been up here between Estes Park and Boulder, about an area in triangle up there to about Loveland. Other than that, eastern plains today have been pretty clear. Most of the showers have gone that way towards Kansas. Goodbye and good riddance, at least for the weekend, let's hope. Take a look at the satellite. We find clouds tonight, but most of them are to the south of Colorado, and we have a flash flood watch out for some of these clouds producing rainfall in eastern and southern New Mexico. All of these clouds are part of a warm, moist air mass. There's no front in here anywhere, just this warm air coming up and heavy showers across to Texas and into Oklahoma, as we'll see here. Amarillo, Texas, in the Panhandle area, set a record for the month of July for a 24-hour period, 4 1/42 inches of rainfall. Heavy rain also extends across Oklahoma, the Tennessee, Ohio Valley regions, most of the southeast and all the way to the Atlantic. And some rain up here across Michigan also from this front. Complex area of fronts across this region. But across the northern plains, northern Rockies, all the way to California, generally warm temperatures, sunny skies. The exception to that would be Washington, where a low-pressure system is sitting in up there. And at the upper levels of the atmosphere, there's another little front coming in. Another little low-pressure system coming in that's bringing a little bit of rain to some coastal sections. Try that word. Here we go. At 18,000 feet tonight, we find out that the jet stream, which is all important in determining our weather, is changing a little bit. Before, these winds were coming straight into the northeast for us. Now, what we see happening is the center of this high pressure right here in California is moving to the east. As that happens, the jet stream will get pushed to the north. These are winds, of course, moving from west to east, and we call this the storm track. When that goes up to the north, that's where the storms are going to go, and they're going to stay out of Colorado. We'll be high and dry for a little while. 53 degrees overnight low last night in Denver. Happened at about 5 minutes after midnight. And then 78 for a high today. That's a bit of warming. Record low on this date, record high, that should be 100 degrees. Record low, 43. Your normals are 88 and 60 on this date. And other than that, air quality, here's some bad news for all of you. Poor today, 114, the number, ozone at the Kerry Station at 21st and Julian was the air quality stat today. 555, the sunrise, 815 for the sunset. To forecast our own state now, eastern Colorado will return up into the 80s and possible low 90s in some sections. 75 to 85 in the mountains, western Colorado from 80 to 94. Denver's forecast, we're going to return to some warm weather too. Not tonight necessarily. 55 tonight's low, partly cloudy sky. Still some possible showers around, but they should be mostly in the foothills. And then tomorrow, mostly sunny. We'll call it about 87 degrees tomorrow. A low of 57 degrees tomorrow night. Slight chance of some showers. We'll look for the isolated types. That's tomorrow. Now, I hope you're ready for the extended forecast. I'll give you that a little bit later. We're looking at 90s again.
We're waiting with bated breath.
I'm sure you
are. Wait for them 90s. And we can take that, safe to take the extra blanket now, back off the bed. And
safe for a few days.
All right.
Safe.
Thanks, Steve.